I want to welcome all of you here this evening. I had a very dear friend who had a very interesting twist on the type of program we're going to have tonight. There is a line in Milton's great epic, Paradise Lost, where he describes Adam and Eve eating for the first time of the fruit, and he says that all nature groaned. And my friend didn't believe it. He said it wasn't all of nature that fell, because the Lord protected music. A little piece of heaven, a little piece of the purity of the Spirit. And through music, he argued, we fallen creatures can still get a glimpse of the divine. I don't know if I agree with his theology, but I love his thought. And it's on evenings like this that it is the most important and the most winning to me. We're going to share a glorious stretch of sacred music as we enter the season that is probably the greatest of the family seasons, because the Lord is our family. So I would ask you all to bow your heads and join me as I ask the Lord to join us. Our loving Father, Jesus Christ, we thank you very much that you have loved us. And we love you because you loved us first and you gave us the great gift of coming so that we could have eternal life. And so tonight we want to give a gift back to you. And the best gift that we know how to give is the music that you have permitted us to make. So join us, Lord, we pray, as we give to you the best we know how. Amen.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Carol Swinier, and I'm an adjunct professor with the Music Department of Atlantic Union College and the director of Thayer Performing Arts Center, our community music school. Thank you so much for coming this evening. We appreciate so much your support and your interest. I hope you have been blessed so far by the music and the message of the music, the timeless and beautiful story of the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. I hardly made it through that last piece as I was thinking of what I was singing. I wish you could be up here singing as well, because you need to express that feeling to the Lord. If you haven't done it lately, go home and do it tonight. Tell him how glorious he is, how wonderful he is, how much you appreciate him. And go out on the mountaintop if you need to and just let it out. We were able to let it out tonight, and it is fabulous. It is just fabulous to be able to sing to him with all we have. Tonight, you know that there are expenses that are involved with something like this. So I ask if you are able to share a little bit of what you have with us to defray the expenses. If you would like a tax receipt, you can write a check or put it in an offering envelope. And we thank you very much. As the ushers, these musician ushers, very talented ushers, begin taking up the offering. Go ahead, folks. I would like to call your attention to the music insert that you had with your program. You see all the programs that are coming up in the next 2 weeks. Oh my, this is music season. And it is a wonderful season, and when it's over, all the musicians will just collapse and hope that somebody takes care of them for Christmas Day. But it is a wonderful season for you if you want to come to all of these things or any of these things. There is one thing that was not listed on the insert, and shame on me, it's tomorrow. I left it off, and it is our Vespers here at 3:30, right here in the church, a festival of lessons and carols, very traditional type of program with reading of the scripture story of Jesus and carols. You will be involved in it. You will be singing with us. So I invite you to that. And I also would like to point out something else that wasn't in the program, and that is that our percussion coordinator was not able to be with us this evening, Dr. Grimes, and in his place, we really appreciate Brian Vogel. Brian, thank you so much. That was very much a last-minute thing, and we just appreciate it so much. So again, thank you so much for coming, and thank you for your gifts of love to us tonight to help us pay for the expenses.
Please stand with me for the benediction. And now may the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace as we trust in him, so that we may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. And now unto the King eternal, immortal, invisible, the only wise God, be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen.